Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So, okay, we actually got a new unit since few days ago. Yeah, since September 5, which is 5 days ago. And honestly, I didn't open Brave Frontier for a few days, maybe that 5 days? And yeah, finally we can get the Vortex Arena reward. So yeah, I made it into the top 1500, and of course we have this new event. Okay, I think I'll do it on the next video. We still have plenty of time to do that. Okay, so before I start to summon the new unit, I will give my first impression review for the new unit QiuTong or QiuTong or whatever you guys call her. Yeah, I think different country will have different kind of spelling her name. Okay, let's just spell her as QiuTong in this video. Could be different though. Okay, light element. The leader skill. 100% boost all parameters. Damage taken usually boost BP gauge. May restores HP. Negates critical elemental damage. And 20% damage reduction to one turn when damage taken as exceeded certain amount. 5000. Okay. Decent mitigation leader skill in my opinion, but too bad that it doesn't have 15% mitigation from all elements and stuff. Yeah, because this one doesn't stack with the other leader skill. I mean, if you are using friend with this kind of leader skill, it won't stack. Yeah, one will get applied. But okay, Mary Star's HP 50% chance is actually quite decent too for mitigation. So a not bad leader skill in my opinion. BB. Okay, I just read her skills just now actually. And she is very interesting because she is a mitigator. Yeah, you can get mitigation buff from her BB SBB for 2 turns. And then she has slightly boost OD gauge, 10% on BB and 12% on SBB. So okay, she is kind of like Xenon version 2. Yeah, Xenon also have mitigation and also add OD gauge, which makes Xenon extremely powerful and usable for the 0 PC core squad unlimited UBB. Yeah, you can use the UBB right from the first turn and you can do it repeatedly. Yeah, by the way, the UBB also have OD gauge 50%, just like Xenon. Okay, so she is very powerful for that part. And then the other buffs, damage taken hugely boosts BB gauge, which is only available on BB. Yeah, it is not available on the SBB, the BB gauge when taking damage. And then negates critical and elemental damage for 3 turns on BB, not available on the SBB, so only BB. And spark damage reduction 50% for 3 turns. So, okay. Only from BB, once again. So, negates critical damage, elemental damage, and spark damage reduction, and also damage taken usually boost BB gauge only on BB. And then from the SBB, we can get boost on critical hit rate 60%, attack defense recovery 200%. Critical hit rate 60% for 3 turns. Well, actually, since she already have this, the boost on critical hit rate is kinda meaningless because it is capped at 70%. Yeah, including the base critical hit rate 10%. Yeah, it will be capped at 70%. Okay, so attack defense recovery, boost critical hit rate, and light elemental damage 225%. Insane amount of buff. Wow, okay. Yeah, this buff effect is very high, 225%. And yeah, attack defense down debuff. Whoa, a mitigator with OD gauge boost, attack defense down debuff, and also critical hit rate, light elemental damage. Wow, this is very good. But only one AoE. Both BB and SBB. Is it truly only one AoE? Yeah, it seems so. Only one AoE on both BB and SBB, so pure mitigator role. Not going to use her as a nuker. The UBB, 100% mitigation for 3 turns and damage taken hugely boosts BB gauge 50 BC, OD gauge 50%. Awesome, just like, you know, Xion in terms of usefulness. I mean, you can get 100% mitigation and also add OD gauge 50%, along with attack defense recovery 450% for 3 turns. So rest in peace Xion CBB. Totally rest in peace Xion CBB. This one is much better. And lastly, light elemental damage 500%. Wow. Okay, very powerful. And this one is very, very powerful. BC cost minus 10% for all allies on the extra skill, which means if we bring 3 of these units in your arena squad, you will already get 30% BC cost reduction. If your leader skill also have 30% BC cost reduction, it's already 60%, and now your squad can already get 0 BC cost effect in arena, even with the normal 20% BC cost reduction spheres. Wow. Okay, this is very good. 10%, yeah? 20% boost to all parameters for all allies, okay. 5% damage reduction for all allies. Really? Really? What? This one is an OP mitigator then. Okay. Okay, and probable 15% damage reduction to 1. Wow, very good mitigator, man. And if we use 3 of these units in the squad, I think we are going to get 15 damage reduction for all allies. Yeah, I think it will stack. Whoa, really? BC cost minus 25% SP skill. So she's kind of made for that kind of unlimited UBB. The one turn unlimited UBB, 0 BC cost squad. Okay, okay, she's definitely for that kind of squad. So if you don't have Sinon, get this unit. You can build your unlimited UBB squad already. Oh, you must have Raphael, by the way. Okay, and then 80% boost to all parameters, not bad. Elemental weakness damage 200%, okay, that's high. Damage taken boost BB gauge, not really recommended. This one is must get, in my opinion. Negates all status elements. Could be good, could be optional. Oh, here we go. Adds all elemental damage reduction 15% for 3 turns effect to BB SBB. Wow, so very, very decent mitigator. Not only decent, very powerful mitigator, to be exact. And 20% DOT mitigation. Wow, perfect mitigation buffs. The normal mitigation, elemental mitigation, and DOT mitigation all in one unit. Wow. And critical elemental vulnerability infliction for 2 turns effect during SPP. Okay, nice, but I think this one is optional. She's not the kind of unit that was made for the damage. So this kind of SP skill is optional. This one is very good, but also optional. Boost attack relative to max HP. A good buff, but also optional. If you think that you are not going to need this from her, you can try to get this, but I think this one is optional. This one boosts attack relative to max HP. This one boosts attack defense recovery relative to max HP. So maybe this one is the requirement to get this, the bottom one. Maybe. Adds max HP boost effect. Completely optional. Okay, this one is must get. BC cost minus 25%. Okay, very, very powerful mitigator. And okay, let's try to get her. Yeah, at least one. At least one. If I able to get her under 10 pull, I might going to try to get the second one. Yeah, she is very powerful. Very, very powerful. So let's do this. The first pull. 7 new files. Nugget. Oh, QiuTong punch. No, that downloading trolled me once again. Okay, Yisui, the fourth pull. Oh, Tranquilizer. Yeah, one of the most powerful units from the Japan version. But it's already old. Nebiro. Six. QiuTong? Nope. Nyala. Seven. Come on, QiuTong, QiuTong, whatever you guys spell it. The Estima. Too old already. Eight. Three. Ninth. QiuTong, QiuTong, QiuTong. How to spell her name? Tenth. Hmm? Ah, only rainbow. Not going to appear from this gate. Carol, hey. Hey Carol, once again. Maxed up already. 11th. Nope. 12. Oh, Gundam. 13th. QiuTong, come on. I think I still need the downloading bar for her. 14th. Oh, I think this is the one. QiuTong. Punch. No, punch. Yes. Okay. Okay, it seems that I'm kind of lucky today. Oh, she's the Mochi Pounder girl. Okay, any type will do, but I will be happy if this one is Anima. So Anima Punch Breaker, okay. Alright. 14 pulls. I can consider that one as lucky. Okay. So I will stop. I will stop. I will save my gems for maybe the next new unit. Yeah, if only I got QiuTong in under 10 pulls, I might going to do for the second one. But okay, one is enough, I think. Okay. So yeah, I think that's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe now if you haven't. And see you again next time. Bye bye. Brave Frontier Global Punch.